65 men walked out of prison today, men the U.S. calls dangerous. Their release is sparking outrage. And ABC's chief White House correspondent Jonathan Carl has the latest on how this happened.
Just yesterday, they were locked in a high-security prison considered some of the most dangerous men in the world, Taliban fighters captured by U.S. forces. Today, they're enjoying lunch in a Kabul cafe, freed under order of Afghan President Hamid Karzai. Among them, an alleged Taliban commander named Nurullah.
I have no link with any groups.
He denies the charges, but has been directly linked to attacks killing at least one American and wounding four others. All told, 65 prisoners were released today from this prison, seen in this exclusive video shot by the BBC. U.S. officials say they are directly linked to attacks that killed or wounded 32 U.S. and coalition personnel.
Many of these people were caught red-handed. The tests on their fingers of explosives on their hands.
It's another low point for already tattered U.S. relations with President Karzai, who has been trying to get his own peace deal with the Taliban.
It is of no concern to the U.S. and should be of no concern to the U.S.
President Obama still has to decide how many U.S. forces should remain in Afghanistan after the end of the year, but today's prisoner release is the kind of thing that makes it harder for the U.S. to remain in Afghanistan at all. Diane?
All right. Jonathan Carr reporting in from the White House.